Assalamu alaikum. I'm Asad Yusuf and welcome to MPT channel. Today we're going to cover ICRU Report 91. So ICRU Report 91 is specially designed for SRT and it's published in 2017. We are going to cover a specific topics, so start with prescribing history. Historically, dose prescription in SRS has been used using so-called coverage isodose. Minimum target dose was related to technique using fixed circular collimator. Clinical results are published since the late 1970s. Historically, dose prescription in SRS has been using the so-called coverage isodose, minimum target dose, and was related to technique using the fixed circular collimators. Prospective data demonstrate the local control for benign malignant tumors together with low toxicity in target, less than 3 cm treated with single fraction. Large variation in the prescription method, no strict recommendation for dose prescription until the present time. In absence of recommendations, dose prescription in SRT as a dose delivered to the outer PTV border or an isodose surface that most optimally conform to the PTV surface. As a percentage of maximum dose, restricted dose to the OAR was achieved. So, till now, there is no recommendation. So ICRU 83, the previous report of photon beam MRT, emphasized the dose prescription at the median PTV doses. ICRU 91 for photon beam SRT, what's the difference? Less normal tissue within the PTV with respect to non-SRT treatment and possible critical structure very close to the PTV. Small volume treated with multiple small fields imply dose heterogeneity to maintain the optimal conformity, acceptability, steep dose gradient. Technical considerations affecting uncertainties, dose calculation algorithm, dose calculation grid, parameter of beam model. So while doing a planning SRT, one must take into consider that what planning station they are using, what algorithm that planning station is utilizing. A dose calculation grid is quite important, and how the beam modeling was done, what beam modifier are used, like MLCs, and what tolerance MLCs have. So everything has to be incorporated before planning SRT cases. The recommendation for SRT prescription, define planning aim, constraints on OAR, prescribe a set of accepted values. Absorbed dose is prescribed to the isodose surface that cover an optimal volume of the PTV while optimally restricting the dose to the PRV. Optimal in this context means the best possible coverage of PTV according to the clinical situation, example, brain mat, spine. But here, point we ICR report is raising that one must use target coverage instead of isodose level. So, dose prescription. Again, what we have to talk about that historically, the prescription being frequently defined as intended marginal dose, which does not always donate the specific target coverage. Dose prescription to the specific percentage as a dose level, example 80%, does not necessarily guarantee the consistent target coverage. The use of gradient index for isodose level selection could be not fully correct. The target concept is missing. The modified gradient index could be better used. The dose prescription to an isodose level is not a concept born in radiotherapy, since the prescribed dose is not an indication of the delivered dose. tolerance of target dose heterogeneity is still clinically important. So as a radiation oncologist, as a physicist, one must keep in mind all these points before planning. And again, what we are following right now in our clinics, that like in the clinics of Gamma and I followed, 20 gray prescribed at 50% isodose, give 40 gray max. Whereas a CyberKnife gave 70% isodose, so 28 gray max. If you go with the 90, it will be 22 gray max. SRS could cause necrosis. A very high dose point shall be avoided. Why one is using 50% isodose line? Look, Gamma Knife has a very tight tolerances. And CyberKnife has a bit lower tolerance, so they are prescribing the higher isodose line as compared to Gamma Knife. When we go to the LINAC, you're using 80% or 90% isodose line. So there is a variation, and this variation is because of the mechanical tolerances and the machine specifications. So instead of going with this, our trainer in Italy recommended that we should follow ICRU 91 and prescribe the dose on our target coverage. Again, when we are prescribing an isodose line, so the higher maximum dose require more mu's, larger integral dose, longer irradiation time. So these are some drawbacks of prescribing on isodose line. Low isodose prescription needs smaller field size. Large dosimetric error could occur. Now, let's do an exercise, and this is what our trainer has shared with us, that they have made three dynamic conformal arc, 120 each at couch angles. We set around the spherical of PTV, 2 cm diameter, LNC shape in contrast with the PTV, zero margin around the PTV. So isodose level outside the target are not perfectly conformed to the target. Higher dose level better conform the target. So same identical plan was normalized to prescribe dose of 20 gray, and they are prescribed on the different isodose lines, and this is the DVH. And one could see if we are going with the target coverage, it's quite closer to 70% isodose line. And it's around 70%, 76% isodose line. And these are the mean doses, and these are the comparable. Now, if you increase the margin by 1 mm or decrease the margin minus 1 mm, then how the result would be. And this is what minus 1 mm, its target coverage is equal to 62% isodose line. So one may consider this thing as well, because the gradient, if you talk about the gradient, it's minus 1 mm gradient is quite good. So in summary, one could go with the zero margin or minus 1 mm margin along with the target coverage. And you can see the dose gradient. So the recommendation of reporting brief clinical history include description of clinical examination, location, diagnostic technique, treatment intent, patient simulation devices are quite important. Target volume, OR selection, delineation, how the clinician is taking all the volumes into account, and how the normal tissues are drawn. Planning aim and dose volume constraint should be defined. Description of treatment planning system, very important. Prescription, patient-specific QA, delivery, verification system is there, and the dose report, and dose in a PTD if applicable. So recommendation, or again for ICRU, is PTV median absorbed dose, T50. In SRT, if the volume is less than 2 cm³, then one must report the cubic volume of 30 mm, 35 mm cube of maximum dose and a minimum, again similar thing. OAR and PRV has to be considered whether you're dealing with parallel organ, stereal organ, and cerebellar organ, and one can differentiate these organs as well, and those recommendations are given. CTV and PTV is defined largely to accommodate the alignment and motion and uncertainties. The treatment plan is frequently designed such that PTV receive a low dose at its boundary than its body. Since it is unlikely that CTV is always located near the edges of the PTV, the dose actually delivered to the CTV is likely to closer to the desired distribution than DVH of the PTV would suggest. Thus, the DVH of the PTV will tend to exaggerate the homogeneity of the dose of CTV. Due to setup error or motion, similarly, the DVH of CTV will tend to indicate more homogeneity than is actually the case. So the dose homogeneity has to be measured. Whereas in SRT, dose homogeneity is not taken into account much because mostly people are looking for conformity and the gradient. So the dose conformity, one could use this formula suggested by Nakamura. And for the dose gradient, one could use modified gradient, which I have not covered in this thing. The drawback of prescribing an isodose line is that we are not able to report what we have delivered. The focus of reporting and target coverage is that we are able to define what is delivered, what is prescribed. So there is a distinguish between everything, and one could identify stuff. So think about it and share your comments and your comments box how you are practicing in your clinic. Thank you very much for your time. And this the presentation is from Humanities Center, where I visited for the clinical school. And this is our team. These are the groups attended the presentation.